So first of all, I thanks to Dr. Ranjit because I submitted my abstract very late, right? Anywho, he accepted because I am not going to here present any research or anything like something like that. Research only for the youngsters. You can do a lot of work. This is based on my crime scene experience because as many of you know, I was a crime scene investigator in India, Tamil Nadu for more than 20 years. That's why they called to Malaysia to teach forensic science. So here some of the psychological aspects in some of the crime scene, what it is, sometime you can identify the psychology people there, right? How they are doing this one. Because they have no criminal intention. Normally, we have what is called for the fire, sometime they intentionally set fire. They are criminals, right? But here, these people, you know, they are doing the setting fire without their knowledge what they are doing or something like that. So that is the difference between the normal criminals as well as the psychology people here. So there I investigated many cases just here because of the time limitations, only 8 minutes, right? Only 8 minutes I cannot give more information about it, many crimes, just
Yeah,
only one
Professor
crime scene.
Murthy, Professor Murthy, I just want to make one request. Can you make this a full mode?
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Right. So, likewise, I'm giving the only one crime scene where I investigated, right? So, normally, this one, all of you know, this one psychology, normally, this is application of psychological knowledge to the legal system, right? So, here, what they are thinking, what they are doing, so that is the main idea of this one. As already told you, sometime they are taking the fire or their weapon to relieve their tension or some psychological behavior or something like that, right? So here we call this arson. Arson means a willful malignation of burning property. Intentionally they set fire. Some other property or their own property. Own property means for the purpose of claiming insurance. For example, they have a car, right? So the worth is only 40,000 rupees. But they claim, say, for example, the 100,000, 1 lakh or 2 lakh. So with the intention, what they do is they have removed some of their internal radio, TV, something like that. Then they set fire. Right? So like that also, some of the people they are doing, internally their own property for the purpose of claiming insurance. So if it is so, what they do, they are called the arsonist. Right? So they are doing the criminal activity of this one. Right? So this one already told you, the fire play a very vital role in the psychology because fire is associated with the love, aggressions, the destruction. There are so many things will be involved in the fire investigation of this one. So normally here, what they do is the exact reason for anything like that, we cannot answer why they are doing or something like that. But sometimes we can identify this one. And if you do the interrogations, normally whenever go to the crime scene, I never stop only by every collection evidence and just return. I won't do it. I just make an inquiry to all the people, whether it is a house or in a factory or whatever it may be. I make a thorough examination of all the inmates, whether it is 100% or 200%. I never bother. I individually inquire them. So then only we can get some idea. Physical evidence, of course, we are collecting. That is not the only way or only role in the crime scene investigation, right? So likewise, if it is so, what to do is I make a thorough investigation of the inmates also. So like a fire setting, normally the psychology, the affected people, what they do here, they wanted to relieve the tension or their aggression through fire setting, right? So that's what I am doing this one. So normally here, according to the American National Center for Analysis of Violent Crime, what is called the motives. Motive means they have some intention in that. So we have to set fire or something like that. So like they are classifying so many motives, profit motivator, vandalism, excitement, revenge, crime consumer. So they are all done by the criminal activity. Whereas at the bottom, they are all because of the psychology people there, socio-cultural, severely disturbed, delinquent. So this is the difference between the criminal set fire as well as the psychological set fire. So this is one of the case study. I have no photo. Actually, as the earlier the Dr. Sarangi told that this is from my memory because I visited many thousands of crimes in India, but I have some of the cases I have photo, right? Because I never thought I would become an academician in Malaysia during the crimes investigation. So I have some of the cases I have photos, And some of them, I don't have the photo, but the case is still in the mind because I plan to write a paper for this one to publish in a journal of this one. So this one, I am not giving the any photos or anything like that, but accordingly, I'm giving the information in this one, right? So here, what it is, in my jurisdiction, there was a private clinic was there. A private clinic was there. So there, suddenly there was some fire risk notice. Normally, it comes to the notice of police after 1 week. So what it is, in the clinic, suddenly there is a fire occur there. So what to do is immediately all the members, the staff there, they just put up there something like that, the first day. And similarly, the second day, what you do, there is another fire in the same place. Minor fire, not major fire or something like that, some minor fire. But immediately all the staff, they extinguish the fire. So likewise, the process is going for 3 or 4 days, right? So in different areas within the clinic itself, in different sites, suddenly it catch fire at the morning 11 o'clock, sometime evening 4 o'clock, something like that. So in the clinic, the ground floor is the clinic, and the upstairs, the doctor is staying there, the doctor and his wife, and he is one small child, 4 years old, right? And the another one, they did not complain to the police. The reason is, what they do, it's a minor, the minor fire, no need to complain to the police, because when you complain to the policeman, a lot of procedure we have to follow. Sometimes we can close the clinic. Something like that is the idea of the doctor. And also the doctor was a rationalist because some of the things he never did. He is a rationalist. He don't want to complain to the police also. But even though the process he continued this one, it goes on nearly 4 or 5 days. The wife, he was worried because he told his husband, so every day is going on like that. Luckily, all are the occurring in the daytime. Suppose if it's the night times, what happens? Suppose the fire may come upstairs, we are all sleeping. Something like that, the advisor, we can't complain to the police. Something like that. So the local people, what they do is, they told that, so this is the act of the shaman. Shaman means some witches from the other side, they are sending fire to the clinic. That is the local the people's belief, right? You know what is the meaning of shaman, Dr. Aruna?
Yeah.
You know that what is the meaning of shaman activity?
Oh yeah, I know.
Because sometimes in the Kerala they have a different name, right? Different area have a different name. So likewise, the local people, it's a small town, so they have the belief the doctor has some rivals, so they are sending fire to this clinic directly from some area. So that is the belief. Right, the doctor also, he is not interested. Then because of the compulsion of his wife, he told him, we can't give a complaint to the police station because every day is occurring. Something like that, because of the pressure of his wife, they lodged a complaint in the police station. Then they immediately called me. Sir, there is a frequent fire here. Then I told them, what you have done, what's any idea? No, sir, we have no idea. You are the expert. You have to come and solve this one. Then I came to the clinic. As I told you, I make a thorough examination of all the places, nearly 6 or 7 places. There are very, very minor fires, not major fire or something like that. They just put up. Then I examined everything like that. Then they have the nearly 6 staff that are paramedical staff and a clerk. There are 6 staff that are there. I inquire separately. Normally, I never inquire as a group, right? Separately, all our girls. All our girls, I made a thorough inquiry, get all the information, and also make a round in the clinic. What are the places? There are consultancy room. There is a small mini lab for the testing the blood and urine, right? So at that time, there was no gas connection, everything like that. They are using a spirit lamp, right? Of course, this generation, they may not know what is the meaning of spirit lamp. Now, everything, we have the gas, right? Those days, we are wearing the firewood in the house. Suppose if they are cooking, mean lot of smoke in the house, meaning that we are cooking, right? At that time, there was no gas or something like that. So likewise, at that time, I just make a thorough examination of this one. Then I come to a conclusion. Then I wanted to discuss the police after that, right? Then after that, so these are all the different places of this one. Then after that, when I just reached the police station, I received another call. So what did he say? Sir, there is another fire, sir. You please come here. So as soon as we just get down into the police station, I received the call. Then immediately returned to the clinic. killing this one. There is a screen is there in the doctor consulting room. It's in front of this one. The door is open. We have the screen. Normally, all of you know this one. At the screen, at the center of this one, they bound. It was burned already. They just extinguished the fire of this one because it is the occurrence immediately. We reached the place within 10 minutes. So when I see this one, there is a small damage, not major tear mark or charring mark, anything like that. Someone smelled this one. But when I smell this one, I feel smelling alcohol, right? Then accordingly, I straight away go to the mini lab, right? Already told you there is a small mini lab is there. So there, I at that time, I just, everything is recorded in my mind. What are the things are there? Where are they? Right? And also, I used to draw a crime scene sketch. I draw the sketch. I say, what are the places within the lab? Where it is there? So where is the almara? Everything, I just make a drawing. So at that time, originally, when I saw the spirit lamp, the lamp was full of rectified spirit, right? We used to say RS. RS means the percentage of alcohol is 98%, right? So like that spirit lamp was found in some other place, not in the same place, and also found empty. So everything is come to my mind. Then I called the doctor. Doctor, who are these people here? I asked all the people, sir, they are all relative. Who is this particular girl? I just talk outside the clinic, myself and the doctor and the DSP. Who are this particular girl? She is also my close relative, sir. So how long she is working here? She is working here for 1.5 years, something like that. Then I told him, it's okay, doctor. Just you need a favor for me. What to do is, you just ask the girl to send some other place for some other work without informing anything like that. You give some assignment so that she can go there. Just to give 1 month work, some work, whatever it may be, you do it one. But don't tell them this was told by me or the police or something like that. Accordingly, the doctor said he was given some assignment to her and asked him to go out. So after that, there was no fire incident. Right? Meaning that I already fixed she is the fire setter. Right? Not a criminal. She is not a criminal. Criminal means he will set the whole clinic, right? So something like that. Then I told her then what to do like that. Then I told her, never mind. I go to the office. So tomorrow you ask the girl to come to my office. I ask the DSP, you send one policeman with her, come to my office, something like that. Then accordingly, the girl come to my office. So I have a separate office. My office is in the district police office. Within this office, I will show my office after this, right? So within the police office, my unit is there. That is mobile forensic unit. Then the policeman come to my office. Then they ask her to, they come to my office. Then I ask the constable, you wait outside. Then I ask the girl, how are you? Where are you? What's your place? Can you take a copy? Can you take the lunch? Or you want any lunch? I will provide. No, sir. Okay, take a coffee. La. You can take coffee.
Professor Murthy, I request, as we are running short of time, can you conclude the presentation?
Yeah. So like that, I was there. And finally told her, you are the accused. I know. You are the accused. Suppose if you did not reply me, you will be arrested, something like that. Then she cried that, so what the problem? Tell her, yes, sir, I only said that, but not intentionally done this one. The reason is I loved a boy, right? But my parents, they separated. So now they are putting here, so I won't go anywhere. I cannot meet him or something like that. Then after that, what I did was, accordingly, I called their parents, then they had a talk with the son, right? Then after that, then I talked to their parents also. And finally, we solemnly their marriage, she accepted. Then I advised the DSP, don't register any case. Don't register case or arrest her. Sir, if it is so, you have to tell the SP. I talked with the SP. So he is not a criminal intention, some psychological fear. Accordingly, based on this one, they never registered case. Then after that, I talked with the boy's parent. I solemnly their marriage. Now she is free from any psychological problem. So this is based on the crime scene work, right? So this is one of the incident in Malaysia wherein there is a fire in the religious school. You can see this is a religious school where the Malay people, they are reading the Quran. So there is a fire. It's occurred there. So this is done by here they are all studying at 10 to 15 years old. The fire was set by some boys, small boys, some juvenile second. It is recorded, you can see in the CCTV, some boys crawling. Actually, they are all the teenagers. So from this school and nearby some school is there. So there is a minor quarrel between the boys. So what did he? He is taking it as a revenge. He is taking it a revenge. What he did was, so he traveled to there. He takes some 3 or 4 boys, taken some small girls in there, get into this night time and open this one. I make a set fire. So nearly 13 people died. Right. So the case is now still going on because now it is in the process of the submission to the court. So likewise, here his intention is not to kill anybody else. Right. Because of their minor quarreling. Right. So these are all the some of the aspects of the psychological aspects in the fire. Right. So based on this one, I am also teaching my forensic science student in Malaysia how we are taking the fire investigation, do something like that. I am taking the students to the fire department. There the exposition, how they are doing, what they are doing, something like that, right? And also, this is my forensic science crimes in vehicle. At the top, you can, that is my vehicle, that is my office, right? And many of the days, I used to sleep in my vehicle only. No time to go home or something like that. So at the bottom, this is the crimes in vehicle in Dubai. I have many friends in all over the country. So here, they are having the separate vehicle for this crime scene vehicle of this one, right? So this is some of the aspects of this one. So this is the forensic science lab in Dubai. I visited this unit before pandemic. Beautiful lab, excellent lab. Lot of instruments, which is not available in India. So like, because they are rich. Whatever they want, they immediately buy from US, right? So likewise, so this is my conclusion of this one. So normally, during the investigation, the crime scene investigator, so whether he is whatever the qualification or whatever it may be, as told Dr. Sarangi, Dr. Sade, mainly the crime scene, not only crime scene experience, you must have the basic knowledge of all subject, which is chemistry, biology, engineering, whatever the subject, you must have the basic knowledge. Then only you can solve the crime, right? Because we cannot depend upon the police officer, something like that. So we have to give a link to the police and solve them. Because in the crime scene, we are assisting the police. I am not the police officer, but we have to support the police. Unless or otherwise you are having the knowledge, they won't respect you. Because in India, I have a lot of, every day I used to go to that crime scene, right? Something like that. So likewise, in the conclusion, whether whatever is psychology or criminology or whatever it may be, the crime scene investigator must have the basic knowledge of science. So that is my conclusion. And thanks are due to Dr. Ranjit Singh, right? I'm submitting very, very late. Very late. Of course, Ranjit has a great affection towards me, right? So he accepted. Right? That's what I'm pressing. So this is based on my crime scene experience, just to share to the youngsters, mainly for the youngsters, right? I have done a lot of research now in Malaysia. During the crime scene investigation, I never do any research. Whatever I am doing in the crime scene investigation, I just present in India, all of you know, All India Police Science Congress, the organized by the BPRNT Delhi. I used in the Andaman Nicobar, Gujarat, Trivandrum, right? And many places I visited and present me crime scene, what I have done in the crime scene or something like that. But now in Malaysia, I am doing a lot of research, lot of, including the psychology, criminology, forensic science, anything I can do this one, right? So that's all for this one. Thank you for your kind attention. Thank you.